Ooh, you brought out the iron. Am I gonna get a tail flattening today?
Nope. Sorry to say, Harry. That's not what it's for. You know, summer's coming around the corner, and people need to open their beers.
HodgePodge. I like your beaver. I really like your beaver!
Oh, and there's nothing better in Texas than beavers, beers, and shotguns, huh?
Exactly, Harry. Now, how do you work this thing? Harry, have you ever used an iron?
Robert, do I look like a house beaver to you? I'm a butch beaver.
Alright, well, the part we are interested in is this little brass end cap. So we place them here on the iron, and then the plastic will soften so we can pull it off. A crescent wrench works great holding the end cap, because it'll be hot.
Yeah, just like me.
Now we wait a few minutes, and you'll see the plastic begin to deform near the brass, and then you can just pull it off. Come on, Harry, sit up. You're on camera.
Alright.
Look at that, Harry. The shell in front of you is melting. You can tell at the bottom there. Time to remove the plastic. And there you have it.
Well, let's go clean up the ends of this wood here.
And now we drill a hole for the threaded insert.
So now, Robert, you're gonna take that Gorilla 5-Minute Epoxy and glue in the brass insert?
That's right, Harry. You're such a smart beaver. Make sure to try to clean off the threads of any epoxy you might get on them. Although it's not that big of a deal, because it'll just come off when you thread them together. And there we go. But let's wait longer than 5 minutes, because that's a lie. Takes a lot longer to dry than that.
I'm ready to get turning, Robert.
Not today, Harry. I'll be doing the turning.
Aw, man.
Alright, let's make this a little shorter. So inside this little cap here, you've got this bump, and you got to drill a hole in the wood to accept that bump.
Looks just a little too big. I get that all the time.
All right, fits perfect now. Uh-oh, I thought we were gonna get it off.
Put a little CA glue there to hold it in place, huh?
That's right, Harry.
Robert will now do the second one out of spalted pecan, but we'll speed it up at 600% so they can see the full process. This really becomes a quick little project that you can make a nice bit of money from. Now, for a quick and easy luster, Robert applies some Odie's oil. Man, that stuff smells good. Alright, time for a beer.
No, not for you, Harry. You've got two more of these to turn.
Oh, too late. I'll do it later.